Hello friends, welcome you to Best Engineers YouTube channel. Today let me see engineering mechanics question from GATE 2015 session 1. Two identical trusses support a load of 100 newton. Two identical supports a load of 100 newton as shown in figure. The length of each truss is 1 meter. Cross sectional area is 200 millimeter square. Young's modulus E is 200 gigapascal. The force in the truss AB in Newton. We should find the force in this truss. Let's see the concept. Here the concept: when three forces meeting at a point, we can go for Lamy's theorem, that is sine law. Three forces meeting at a point, we can apply Lamy's sine law. Let's draw the free body diagram for this truss structure. Here weight 100 newton acting. Here the force FBC, FAB. This angle is 30 degree and 30 degree. So this angle is 180 minus 60. So this value is 120 degree. Here the angle is 90 plus 30. This angle also 120 degree. This angle is also 120 degree. Now by sine law, Lamy's theorem, 100 newton divided by opposite sine angle sine 120 equal FBC divided by sine 120 equal FAB divided by sine 120. The force will be equal to the opposite sine angle between other two forces, that is sine law. Now we can able to solve this 100 newton divided by sine 120 equal FAB divided by sine 120. We can cancel this. We will get FAB equal 100 newton. This is a force acting on member AB. This value is 100 newton. Let's see the next question. For the truss shown in the figure, the magnitude of the force in the member RR and the support reaction at the R respectively. We should find the force in the member PR and the reaction at R. Let's see the concept. When a pivoted point is there, there will be two reactions. Here is two type of contact. One is pivoted contact. When the hinged support is acting, there will be two reactions: vertical reaction and horizontal reaction. When the roller support is there, there will be only vertical reaction. There will not be horizontal reaction. Let's draw the free body diagram for this truss structure. We can resolve this force into horizontal and vertical component. So there will become two forces. That is, this value is 100. This value is 100 kN. We can resolve that into two components: vertical component force and horizontal component force. This will become 100 cos 60, 100 sine 60. Here at point Q is hinged support, so there will be two reactions. R, this point is Q, R Q vertical, R Q horizontal. This point is roller support, so there will be only vertical reaction. This point is R, so R vertical, there will not be any horizontal reaction. Now take the moment about point Q, because we should find the reaction at this support. We should find the magnitude of force in PR, which this force and support reaction R respectively, and reaction at this R. Take moment about point Q, R into this total length is 4 meter, so this and this also 4 meter, because this angle is 45, this angle is 90, so it should be 45. Length and height are same, into 4 equal RRV into 4 counterclockwise moment, and 100 cos 60 into 4, 100 cos 60 into 4. So RR equal 100 cos 60. So the reaction RR equal cos 60. So this reaction will become 50 kilo Newton. This force, horizontal and vertical force, is acting on this member. So there will be force in this member P and R. We can resolve this force into two component, that is F R, this angle is 45 degree, F R P cos 45, F R P sin 45. This force F R P, this F RP force is acting on this member. This angle is 45 degree. While resolving this, we can get two force, horizontal and vertical forces. Now consider this member, only P and Q member. We will get forces like this. Here 100 cos 60, 100 sin 60. F R P cos 45, here F R P sin 45. Now apply the equilibrium equation. F R P sin 45 equal 100 cos 60. So F R P equal 100 cos 60 divided by sin 45. So we will get the force FRP equal 50 root 2. So FRP equal 70.71 Newton. This is the force acting on the member PR. So the answer is 70.71 Newton and 50 Newton. Option C is correct answer. Next question. A ball of mass 0.1 kg initially at rest is dropped from a height of 1 meter. Ball hits the ground and bounces off ground upon impact with the ground. The velocity reduces by 20%. The height in meter to which the ball will rise. Initially, ball kept at some height, U equals 0, mass equals 0.1 kg. This is the ground. It is kept 1 meter height. Ball hits the ground and bounces off ground upon impact. After hitting, it impacts and bounces to some height. It comes from the top and reaches with some velocity V1. And after hitting, it reduces velocity by 20% and bounces back with the velocity, that is V2. We should find this height. H2 we should find. Initially the height is 1 meter. We should find the bounce back height. Let's go the concept and solving. We know that formula V square equal U square plus 2GH. This is formula V square equal U square plus 2AS. For horizontal motion, we will use acceleration and distance like this. It is a vertical motion, so we will change acceleration into gravity and travel distance into the height. Here the object is initially raised, so this initial velocity becomes 0, so V1. Now V1 equals square root of 2GH. After it hits with the velocity of square root of 2GH. Now V2 equal 0.8 V1. It hits with the 100% velocity, reduces 20%, so 80% velocity only will apply for rebound. So this V2 we should find, so 0.8 square root of 2GH, 0.8 square into root of, so V2 equal 0.8 into 2 into 9.81 into 1, and V2 is square root of 2GH2 equal 0.8 into 2 into 9.81, square on both sides, so we will get H2 equal 0.8 into 0.8 into 2 into 9.81 divided by 2 into 9.81, so we will get H2 equal 0.64 meter. After striking, the ball will rebound 0.64 meter. So this H2 is 0.64 meter. Next question. A mobile phone has a small motor with an eccentric mass used for vibrator mode. The location of the eccentric mass and the motor with respect to the center of gravity of the mobile and the rest of the dimensions of the mobile phone are shown. The mobile is kept on a horizontal surface. The eccentric mass is 2 grams and the eccentricity is 2.19 millimeter. Mass of the mobile is 90 gram. Uniform speed of the motor in RPM for which mobile will get lifted off the ground at the NQ. The mobile is going to lift at this Q point with respect to the P. At the NQ approximately, we should find the uniform speed of the motor in RPM at end Q. We should find the velocity Q. We should find the angular velocity here in terms of RPM. Here eccentric mass is 2 grams, 2 into 10 power minus 3 kilogram, and eccentricity E is 2.19 millimeter, 2.19 into 10 power minus 3 meter, and the mass of the mobile 90 gram, 90 into 10 power minus 3 meter. All the weight and eccentricities are converted into in terms of kilogram and meter. Now the mobile is pivoted at point P. Let's draw the free body diagram. This is our mobile. Point P, point Q. Here is CG, mass of the mobile into gravity. Distance from this pivoted point is 6 cm. From here to here, mass of eccentricity is 3 cm. This mass of eccentricity will rotate the object in counterclockwise direction because the mobile is kept on flat surface, so it will rotate in counterclockwise direction with respect to the point pivoted point P. Now taking the moment about P, this force will m e g omega square. So this one is mass. Cg will create the clockwise moment. Mass of mobile into g into 6 equal mass of eccentricity into g into omega square into 9. Now substitute the value here. Mass of mobile is 90 into 10 power minus 3 into g into 6 equal mass of eccentricity is 2.19 into 10 power minus 3 into omega square into 9 into the value of e is 2.19 and mass of eccentricity is 2 into 10 power minus 3. Now let's we take omega square. This minus 3 we can cancel, and g we can cancel here. G is missed here. Omega square 9 into 2 into g, we can cancel this g. So we'll get omega square equal 90 into 6 divided by 2.19 into 9 into 2 into 10 power minus 3. Solving this, we will get omega equal 366.58 radian per second. 1 radian per second equal 1 divided by 2 pi hertz, that is also equal 60 divided by 2 pi rpm. Now multiply with 60 divided by 2 pi, we will get omega in terms of rpm. That value is 3500 revolution per minute. This is the answer for this question. The angular velocity 3500 rpm acted here, the mobile will start lift. Thanks for watching.